Hello everyone, today we are going to see a next type of word problems, that is application to problems based on time, distance and speed. Okay, time, distance and speed. Okay, before starting this, we are going to study something. See here, we all have studied about this rule. Speed is equal to distance upon time. Speed is equal to distance upon time. This formula we are going to use here. Okay. So according to the information we are going to use, if distance we are going to find out distance, then speed into time is equal to distance. Okay. If time we need to find out, then time is equal to distance upon speed. Okay. So like that, this formula we are going to use to solve such type of questions. Okay. One more thing. Upstream and downstream. Okay, suppose stream. Okay, if upstream and downstream is what that we are going to study. See what is mean by upstream. Speed of boat in still water. Suppose speed of boat in still water. If speed of boat in still water is u kilometer per hour, and speed of current is v kilometer per hour. Okay, speed of boat u kilometer per hour and speed of current is stream. Okay, that is v kilometer per hour. Now see here, suppose this is that flow, okay, this is that flow, and boat is here, suppose boat, and this is downstream, okay. So when boat will go downstream, that time its speed is going to increase, definitely speed will increase, okay, because there will be no resistance, so speed will increase, okay. When it will go, this is direction, okay? This is flow, water flow, okay, water flow is this way. Okay, so when boat will go this way, that time its speed is going to increase. Okay, so downstream, when downstream will come, that time what is going to come? Downstream, that time speed of boat plus speed of current, that time what is going to come? U plus V. When it is downstream, that time it will come U plus V. Okay, U plus V kilometer per hour. Okay, upstream, suppose boat will come upstream, this direction, so definitely it will get resistance, so definitely its speed is going to decrease, original speed is u kilometer and it is going to decrease because it will get resistance, so downstream then upstream speed will be u minus v, this is original speed and it is going to decrease by this, because here it will get boat will get resistance, so speed is going to decrease. Okay, so these things we are going to use when downstream will come, that time we need to use u plus v and upstream u minus v. Okay, and this speed is equal to distance upon time. These things we are going to use to solve such type of examples. Okay, so now see here, first example is given. Points A and B are 90 km apart from each other. Point A and B are 90 km apart from each other on a highway. A car starts from A and another from B. A car starts from A and another from B at the same time. If they go in the same direction, they meet in 9 hours. And if they go in opposite direction, they meet in 9 by 7 hours. Okay, find their speeds. Here they are asking speeds. Okay, once again see carefully first statement. What is given? Points A and B are 90 km apart from each other on a highway. Okay, suppose point A is here. This is point A and this is point B. Okay, point A and B are on the same apart from 90 km. Okay, the distance between point A and B is 90 km. So this is 90 km distance. Okay, what is given? A car starts from A, and another starts from B. Okay, at the same time. If they go in the same direction, they meet in 9 hours. Same direction means if direction is this, they will meet in the same at point, next point. Okay, they will meet in after 9 hours. Okay, time is given. So suppose this car, suppose we will say X car and this car we will say Y, and they will meet. Both the cars will meet here. Okay, so this point I am saying this is Q. This point is Q. They will meet at point Q. Getting everyone? So now, if they go in the same direction, they meet in 9 hours. And if they go in the opposite direction. Second, what is given? Opposite direction means this is A point, this is B point. Okay, opposite direction means this will go here and this will come here, this side. Okay, means towards each other they will come. That time, if they go in the opposite direction, they meet in 9/7 hours. Find their space. Okay, if they will come towards each other, this opposite direction. Suppose they will meet here. I am saying that point P. They meet in 9/7 hours. Find their space. Okay, so two cases are given. So first we are going to think about the first case. Okay, here point A, point B. This is, I have given here name car X and car Y, and they will meet, both the cars will meet at point Q. Okay, so now we are going to think about this case. This is first case. I am saying this is the first case, case 1. Okay, so what we say? Okay, later at point A, the car which is starting from point A, that car will be named X. Okay, and so let X and Y be two cars starting from point A. Let X and Y be two cars starting from point A and B respectively. Okay. Car X starting from A and car Y starting from B in the same direction. Okay, and they will meet at point Q. Okay, and both cars will meet at point Q. Okay, this is case first. This is case, we are thinking about case one. Okay, now they are asking find their speed. So we will take the speed of car X. This is capital X, we have written car X B. X small x and using X kilometer per hour. And speed of car Y B small y kilometer per hour. Okay, speed of car X be X kilometer per hour, and speed of car Y will be small y kilometer per hour. Their speeds are different. Why their speeds are different? Because see here carefully, both the cars are starting. First car is car X is starting from point A and car Y is starting from point B, but at point Q, after 9 hours, time is same. After 9 hours, both the cars are meeting at point Q. Understood? So definitely their speeds are different. Then only this is possible. If speed is same, then this is not possible. Okay? Then time will be different. But here time is given constant. Both cars are taking 9 hours. In 9 hours, they will meet at a point Q, here we said. So definitely their speeds are different, and both the speeds that we need to find out. Okay, so here what we have done, see carefully. Let X and Y be two cars starting from point A and point B respectively. Both cars will meet at point Q. If you want, you can write this in first one. You can take in case one. Speed of car X be X kilometer per hour, and speed of car Y be Y kilometer per hour. So now I am taking here case case one. Okay, case one is this. Okay, car, car X and Y will meet at point Q. Okay, point Q. Now this distance is given. AB distance is given 90 km per hour. This distance is given 90 km. Sorry, per hour not 90 km. Distance is given. AB is 90 km is given. Okay. Suppose I want to find out this. This car will start from this point A. Point A will start. Then point this car will start from point B and they will meet at point Q. Okay, so suppose I want to find out AQ. Suppose I want to find out AQ distance. AQ distance. Okay, so how to find out AQ? AQ, how to find out AQ? See, AB is AQ, AQ minus BQ. AQ minus BQ. See carefully. AQ minus BQ. What is going to the AQ minus BQ means what is going to the AB? Is equal to AB. This is our first equation. See carefully. AQ. AQ is the distance, total distance which is covered by car X. And BQ is the distance covered by car B. And this is AB. The difference between these two will be AB. Okay. And AB is given 90 km. So we are taking both the sides, we have taken distance. Okay. Only same units, with the help of same units, we are doing this. Getting everyone? So now AQ, how to find out AQ? AQ is the distance. Okay, we have seen here distance is equal to speed multiplied by time. Distance is equal to speed multiplied by time. Okay, AQ is the distance which is covered by car X. Okay, car X. So its speed we have taken x kilometer per hour, and speed of car we have taken y kilometer per hour, small. Okay, so now I am going to find out AQ, AQ distance. We are finding AQ distance. So distance is equal to speed multiplied by time. So AQ will come, here it will come X. And how much time it takes? 9 hours. 9 hours. Okay. Car X will take 9 hours to reach point X, point Q. And car B will take 9 hours to reach point Q. Okay. So here it will come 9 hours. Okay, distance is equal to speed multiplied by time. Okay, this is time, this is speed. Now BQ. BQ is the distance which is covered by car Y, and its speed is small. Its speed we have taken small. So here it will come small. And time is the same, constant time, that is 9 hours. So it will come 9. Okay, 9x minus 9y is equal to AB. What is the distance AB? 90 km. So it will come 9. Okay, so further you can write x minus y is equal to 10. If you will take here, if you divide by 9 both the sides, then you will get x minus y is equal to 10. Okay, got it everyone? How this came? This is important thing. Okay, this distance minus distance is equal to distance. This both the sides we have taken same unit. Okay, so 9x minus 9y is equal to 9. 9x how it came? 9x AQ distance is 9x, because distance is equal to speed multiplied by time. This is time, this is speed. Okay, speed we have taken here x kilometer per hour of car X, and y kilometer, small y kilometer per hour of car Y. So 9x minus 9y is equal to 9. This is our first equation. Okay, now we will think about case number 2. We will think about case number 2. Okay, so now I am taking that here. Case 2, case 2. Okay, what is case 2? If they go in the same direction, they meet in 9 hours. And if they go in the opposite direction, just now we have discussed here point A and here point B, they will go in the opposite direction. Suppose they will meet here point and point B. This is the second case we are thinking. Okay, so again, what is going to come here? AP plus PB is equal to AB. AB plus PB is equal to A. Okay, so here we are, I am saying here, when car x and y will move in the opposite direction. Opposite direction. Both will meet at point P. Opposite direction means towards each other. Okay. So this is car A and car B will start at the same time. They will meet at point P. Okay. And what is given? See, if they go in the opposite direction, they meet in 9/7 hours. Okay. Again, here we are going to do the same thing. AP distance we are going to find out. Okay. Here AP plus PB is equal to A. AB we have because that is given 90 kilometers. So directly we can put 90 kilometers. AP we are going to find out. AP means car X, which is going to start from point A. So its speed is constant. That is X we are going to take. Okay. Speed we have time. Time what is given? 9/7. So here we can multiply by 9/7. Plus PB. PB is speed is y and time is same 9/7 hours. So here we multiply by 9/7 is equal to AB is 90 kilometers. Okay. So now we can see here we can 9x plus 9y is equal to this 7. Common denominator we can take that side 90 multiply by 7. So here we can take 9x plus 9y is equal to 630. Okay. So now x plus y is equal to 7. This is our second equation. This is our second equation. Now here we have both the equations. Now we can solve by any ways. By substitution solve, by making coefficient same, or by cross multiplication. Any method we can use here. Okay. So now I am doing that here. Directly see equation first is x minus y is equal to 10. And here second equation is x plus y is equal to 7. So by adding both the equations, we will get answer immediately. Okay. So by adding equation first and second, x minus y is equal to 10 and x plus y is equal to 7. So we are doing here addition, plus y minus y cancel. 2x is equal to 80. So x is equal to 80 divided by 2. So x is equal to 40. X is equal to 40 kilometer per hour because this is speed, 40 kilometer per hour. Okay. Means x is the speed of car X, first car, which is starting from point A. Okay. Its speed is 40 kilometer per hour. Now we will put x is equal to 40 in equation first. Put x is equal to 40 in equation first. Equation first is x minus y is equal to 10. So 40 minus y is equal to 10. So minus y is equal to 10 minus 40. Minus y is equal to minus 30. So y is equal to 30 kilometer per hour. Okay. So see here, speeds are different. So they will meet at a certain point because time is given same. Okay. So what did everyone? Two cases we have seen. This is here. What is important? To prepare the equations according to the given information. That is important step. Afterwards you can solve very easy. Okay. So here we need to keep in mind speed is equal to distance upon time. That is first thing. Upstream, downstream. And when both the sides units should be same, means in one side it will take time, in one side it will be distance, that both the things we can't compare. So that also we need to keep in mind. Okay, so see carefully and solve this in your notebook. Okay, see here our next example is Ved travels 600 km to his home partly by train and partly by car. He takes 8 hours if he travels 120 km by train and rest by car. He takes 20 minutes longer if he travels 200 km by train and rest by car. Find the speed of the train and car. Okay, here we need to find out speed of train and car. Understood? So first thing, we will take here speed of train will be x kilometer per hour. Speed of train be x kilometer per hour and speed of car be y kilometer per hour. Okay. Now see, Ved travels 600 km to his home partly by train and partly by car. Okay, total distance is given 600 km. Understood? Now here, he takes 8 hours if we travel 120 km by train and the rest by car. Okay, so we are going to think about this first thing. With the help of this, we will get our first equation. Okay, so Ved travels 120 km by train, that is given. Okay, and total distance is 600 km, that is given. Okay, train and rest by car. So we travel 120 km by train and by car. How will we get by car? 600 minus 120 will be 480 km we traveled by car. Okay, we traveled 120 km by train and 480 km by car. So total is 600. Okay, now what is given? He takes 8 hours. He travels 120 km by train and 480 km by car. Okay, so now see here carefully, 120 km distance and plus 480 km distance, and he took 8 hours to travel both the distance with the help of both pedaling, understood, car and train. Okay, but see here this is distance and this is time. This is distance and this is time. Okay, in LHS distance is given and in RHS time I have taken, which is not correct, understood. Both the sides we must have same unit. Okay, so we need to do something here. Okay, so I told you before this, speed is equal to distance upon time. In here what is given? 8 hours is given. So all the units must be in hours only. Okay, hours means in time. So here see how I will get time. Time is equal to distance upon speed. Time is equal to distance upon speed. Why we have done these changes? Because here it is given time. This is total, it is given in time. So all the units, all the terms in LHS that we are going to convert into time. Okay. So this is 8 hours. So see what is 120 km by train. Okay. So 120 km by train, this is distance. And speed we have taken x kilometer per hour of train. So speed is, distance is 120 and speed is equal to x kilometer per hour. Okay, so what is the time? Time will be distance upon speed. So 120 upon x. Understood? So this is covered by the train. So now according to the given information, what is going to come? 120 by x plus, this is covered by the train. Now we are going to find out distance covered by the car. Okay, so distance covered by the car is 480 km. So that distance I am taking here 480 km. Speed of car we have taken here y km/h. Okay, so time is equal to distance upon speed. So distance is 480 divided by 1. So here it will come 480 divided by 1. So this is in time plus time is equal to how much it will take? 8 hours. So now this is the valid equation. Okay, this was given in time. So the terms which are coming in LHS we have converted into time only. Understood? With the help of speed is equal to distance upon time, that formula. Okay, this is covered by train and this is speed. So distance upon speed is equal to time. So this term is time plus this is covered by the car upon speed of car. So this is also time. Time plus time is equal to time. What did everybody? This is important statement. So now This is our first step. Okay. So I am taking this equation, equation number one. Equation one. Now we will think about equation number two. Okay. Now what is given? See after this. He takes 20 minutes longer if he travels 200 km by train. Okay. Case second. Case second. This is case first. Okay. Case first. 200 km by train. By train. 200 km. Okay. So by car. By car I will get. Total distance is same 600 km. 600 minus 200 km. So that is 400 km. Okay. So now again, if he takes if he takes 20 minutes longer, 20 minutes longer means 20 minutes more. Okay. Means 8 hours plus 20 minutes. 8 hours plus 20 minutes. That 20 minutes we need to add. If he travels 200 km by train. 200 km by train. So here 120 it was there. So 120 and here. Now here 200. Okay. So how the equation will come? 200 is the distance upon speed is going to remain same. So that is x, 200 upon x plus distance covered by car is 400 and speed of car is y. So divided by y is equal to 8 hours and plus 20 minutes. Plus 20 minutes means 20 minutes also we need to convert into hours. So 20 by 60. Okay. 20 minutes from the 60 minutes. So 20 by 60. So here it will come 20. 3 is that. Okay. So 200 upon x plus 400 upon y is equal to 8 is a 24 plus 1, 25, 25 by 3. This is, I am saying, second equation. Okay, so now two equations we have. Now what we need to do, we have seen such type of examples. Okay, suppose I will do here cross multiplication, I will get a term which will contain both the variables and we don't want that. So what we are going to do, we are going to denote here something. Okay, let 1 by x, let 1 by x is equal to u and 1 by y is equal to v. Okay, put 1 by x is equal to u and 1 by y is equal to v. So how first equation you will get? First equation will be 1 by x into 20. So 120 u. So equation first will be 120 u plus 480 v is equal to 8. Okay. This equation 120, how we can write this? 120 multiplied by 1 by x. So 1 by x we have denoted by u. So 120 u plus 480 v is equal to 8. Okay, so this is our first next equation. I am saying this is third one equation. Okay, which we got from first equation. From first. Okay, now this equation now will become 200 u plus 400 v is equal to 20 by 3. Okay, so now here what we can say, this by this 3 we can multiply here. Okay, so 200 into 3 600 plus 4 3 is 1200 v is equal to 600 u plus 1200 v is equal to 25. Okay, so this equation and this equation, this is I am saying fourth one equation which we got from second, which you got from second. Okay, now we need to think about these two equations. Okay, here see 120 is given here, 600 is given. So if I will multiply this equation by 12 5s are 60. So I will multiply this third equation by 5, then I will get 600. So that way we can convert. Okay, by we can make coefficients. So multiply equation third by 5 and subtract from fourth. Okay, subtract from fourth. So this equation I multiply by 5. So 5 in bracket 120 u plus 480 v is equal to 8. 120 u plus 480 v is equal to 8. So what you will get here? 12 5 is 60, 600 u plus this will be 20 plus 4, 24. 2400 V is equal to 8574. Okay, so this equation, and we are saying this is from fourth equation is this 600 U, that I am taking here 600 U plus 1200 V is equal to 25. So now we are going to do subtraction, minus this will be minus, this will be cancelled. 2400 minus 1200 will be 1200 V is equal to 40 minus 25 will be 15. So V is equal to 15 divided by 1200. Okay, so now we can do here 5 is a 15, 1 by 80. Value of V is 1 by 80. Now we need to find out U. Okay, so that U we are going to find out now. Okay, U is equal to this V is equal to 1 by 80. We will put in equation 1. U is equal to 1 by 80 in equation first or second. Any equation we can write. So this is, I am taking first equation, second equation is here. Third equation, equation number third we will put. Equation number third is 120U plus 480V is equal to 8, and here we have V is equal to 1 by 80. So 120U plus 480 multiplied by 1 by 80 is equal to 8. So 0 cancel, 8 6 are 48. So 120U is equal to 8 minus 6. Plus 6 will go that side, it will be minus. So U is equal to 2 by 120, so that is 1 by 60. So U we have 1 by 60. U is 1 by 60, V is 1 by 80. Okay. Now we have denoted here 1 by X. What we have denoted? 1 by X is equal to U. 1 by X is equal to U. So 1 by X is equal to U is equal to 1 by 60. So X is equal to 60 kilometer per hour. Okay, 60 kilometer per hour. Second, we have taken 1 by Y is equal to V. So 1 by Y is equal to V is 1 by 80. So Y is equal to 80 kilometer per hour. Okay. So we have now speed of car and speed of train. Speed of train is 60 kilometer per hour, and speed of car is 80 kilometer per hour. Okay. Once again, see what we have done. Weight travels 600 kilometer. Okay. By train and by car. Okay. Two ways are given. Car and train. It takes 8 hours if you travel 120 kilometer by train and the rest by car. Okay. So we have converted all the units in the time, and then we got the equation. Secondly, it takes 20 minutes longer. So we have taken here 20 minutes longer. So 8 plus 20 by 60. This is distance upon speed is equal to time. Distance upon speed is equal to time, and in RHS time. So the equations are valid. And finally, this such type of equations we cannot solve directly. So we have denoted here 1 by x is equal to u and 1 by y is equal to v. And then we have solved, we got here value of v and u. And finally, we need to put in the wherever we have taken 1 by x is equal to u, and then you will get the proper answer, speeds of the train and car. Okay, so see carefully, these are little bit different examples. So see carefully video, solve both the examples once again, and the worksheet also. Okay, thank you very much.